Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and welcome to this Windows tutorial. Today, we're uninstalling Visual Studio. So let's get started. Fire up Chrome, type Visual Studio Uninstaller into the search field, and click the link that starts with Releases. Click totaluninstaller.zip to download the file, Ace. When it finishes, open the zip file. Extract the file to wherever you like, Ace. Here I'm extracting it to the desktop, but feel free to save it to a different location. Before we start the uninstall process, it's always a good idea to back up your folders and create a restore point. Type System Restore into the Windows search field and click Create a Restore Point. Click Create. Give your restore point a meaningful name and click Create. With all that done, we're ready to start uninstalling. Open the Total Uninstaller folder. Right-click on setup.forceuninstall.exe and click Run as Administrator. When the UAC dialog pops up, click Yes and a console window should open. The text displayed in this window will advise you to use this software as a last resort. In my opinion, this software was the easiest way I could find to remove Visual Studio from my computer. If you're unsure about it or haven't backed up your files, you may want to pass on it. But if you're happy enough, we can get started. Type Y into the console and press Enter. This will start the uninstall process. It can take a bit of time to run it fully, and your mileage may vary depending on how many versions of Visual Studio you have installed. The whole process took about half an hour for me to complete. Once the console window closes, the uninstaller is finished and Visual Studio has been removed. If we pop into Program Files, you'll see that some of the folders have been left behind this. It should be safe to delete these manually, just proceed with caution. Some of the Visual Studio extensions may be left behind as well, Ace. To remove them, open Control Panel and click Uninstall a program. When the dialog pops up, navigate to the extensions you want to uninstall. For me, ReSharper was one of the extensions left behind. Right-click on the extension, click Uninstall, and give it a little time to complete. With all that done, you've successfully uninstalled Visual Studio from your computer, Ace. And that's it! Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Tell me what you think of the pacing for this video. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any other ways to uninstall Visual Studio. I would like to once again thank Rohit Yadav for the original video idea. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.